The red tide algae bloom, now tossing tons of dead fish on Pinellas County's beaches, has been fueled for months by many things. Runoff from over-fertilized lawns, leaking septic tanks and sewage lines, even dust from the Sahara Desert. Now, add another ingredient to the mix, making this the worst red tide bloom in a decade: pollution flowing from the Mississippi River. A 2007 federal study concluded that the extremely large amount of nutrients flowing from the Mississippi into the Gulf of Mexico can stimulate red tide blooms growing on the continental shelf off the west coast of Florida. The lead author of that paper, oceanographer Richard Stumpf of the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, said in an interview this week that that's exactly what happened this year, and it's why this red tide resembles the horrific one from 2005. The nutrients are not what sparked the red tide algae to suddenly bloom, he said, but they do feed the bloom and make it larger. Every possible source of nutrients is feeding it, Stump said, noting the same thing happened in 2005. The only thing that broke up the 2005 bloom? Hurricane Katrina. For the Tampa Bay Times, I'm Craig Pittman.
Want to listen to it?